Greetings. In this video, I would like to discuss some scriptures which might argue against the rapture. And big thanks to my brother Phantom for your support and your encouragement. Let's look at the list of scriptures you provided. Revelation 24. There are saints who are beheaded for not receiving the mark of the beast or receiving the image of the beast. How can saints be around during the mark of the beast and the image of the beast already being set up if we are going to be raptured before the tribulation even starts? I think that is a great question, and I'd group it with the question, who are the tribulation saints? Clearly, there are saints, believers, who live and die during the Great Tribulation. Revelation 12:11, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Revelation 13:7, and he was permitted to wage war against the saints and to conquer them. He was also given authority over every tribe, people, language, and nation. And to conquer them. I'm pretty sure that means kill them. Revelation 24. Then I saw thrones, and they sat on them, and judgment was given to them. And I saw the souls of those who had been beheaded because of their testimony of Jesus and because of the word of God. Beheaded by Islam, the one world religion of the Antichrist. Clearly, there are saints, believers who live and die during the Great Tribulation. So, how can there be saints or Christians after the rapture? I believe there are several facets to understand regarding this issue. And there are at least five possible sources of believers, converts, Christians, even after a rapture. 1. I believe the parable of the 10 virgins implies that some Christians may not go in the rapture, represented by the 5 foolish. Matthew 25:11. Later, the other virgins also came, saying, Lord, Lord, open up for us. But he answered, truly I say to you, I do not know you. These 5 foolish virgins were looking for the bridegroom, which implies they were believers or Christians. Yet there was some missing element of preparation, represented as oil, which disqualified them. They would not go with the bridegroom, represented as the rapture in this scenario. So they would remain and either realize their lack or not, continue living into the events to come. 2. As Jesus mentioned, there will be believers not strong enough to escape. They will evidently remain. Luke 21:36. Watch you therefore, and pray always, that you may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man. If some escape, some do not. The some that do not would be around for beheading. To me, that fits perfectly with Jesus' suggestion to pray that you may escape. Is this analogous to the 5 wise and 5 foolish virgins? I can neither establish nor refute the possibility. 3. I believe right after the rapture, some will convert to follow Christianity when they cannot deny the rapture has in fact happened. I believe our spirits will be raptured, but our dead bodies will remain behind. If that is correct, it will be hard to create a rational cover story for 50 to 500 million dead Christians worldwide. No doubt the willingly ignorant will not question the oft-repeated party line, whatever that is. Source 4. The Bible foretells of the blindness of the Jewish people lifting implying they will then recognize their Messiah, Yeshua. Romans 11:25, "For I would not, brethren, that you should be ignorant of this mystery, lest you should be wise in your own conceits." That blindness in part is happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles be come in. I would call these believers and saints, because they will follow Yeshua. Revelation 12:17, "So the dragon was enraged with the woman, and went off to make war with the rest of her children, who keep the commandments of God, and hold to the testimony of Jesus." We know the woman of Revelation 12 is Israel, so her children are the Jewish people. These are faithful Jewish people who keep the testimony of Jesus. Also, 144,000 Jewish missionaries will go forth and witness for the Lord, assumably winning converts to follow the Lord. Revelation 7:3, saying, "Do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees until we have sealed the bond servants of our God on their foreheads." "And I heard the number of those who were sealed, 144,000 sealed from every tribe of the sons of Israel." And in all five of these cases, I believe that these are born again by the Spirit of adoption, the Holy Spirit. So I do not think the presence of saints to be slaughtered by the Antichrist necessarily refutes a rapture happening. But I also have to address a scripture that confuses the issue. 2 Thessalonians 2:7, "For the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. Only he who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way. And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord Jesus will kill with the breath of his mouth and bring to nothing by the appearance of his coming." Now let's go through that slowly. 2 Thessalonians 2:7, "For the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. Only he who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way." He who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way. I've heard people claim he that restrains is the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, but that is wrong. John 14:26, "And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever." If the Holy Spirit is taken out of the way, and Christians are left behind without the Holy Spirit, that would make Jesus' promise of the Comforter a lie. Because of that, it just does not jive that the Holy Spirit is removed from the earth, taken out of the way. A second problem is that if he that restrains is the Holy Spirit and he is taken out of the way, no one could be born again of the Spirit during the tribulation. None. Nada. Zip. Jesus answered, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." But what if he that restrains are born-again Christians? The Bible speaks of the authority of Christians. "I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." To bind is to restrain, to hold back. Ponder the similarity between he who binds and he who restrains. That is an interesting point to consider regarding who is he who restrains. "For the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. Only he who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way." and then the lawless one will be revealed. I'm not sure if revealed means that the Antichrist is actually known and recognized at this point. This could certainly refer to men of understanding recognizing him, but that is not my real focus on this verse. And bring to nothing by the appearance of his coming. This refers to Jesus' coming. This is a future reference, to follow the revealing of the lawless one. So there is an order to these events. He is taken out of the way, the lawless one is revealed, then Jesus comes and kills the lawless one. Remember, between lawless one revealed and the death of the lawless one, the 7-year tribulation needs to fit in there somewhere. Now it seems to me that if he who restrains is Christians, then taking them out of the way would best be called an abduction, a removal, a sequester. How about the rapture? As a theory, a hypothetical scenario, it seems to match the details. He who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way. Is there a third alternative beside the Holy Spirit and Christians? Not that comes to my mind. But if you have an idea, post a comment and let me know. How can saints be around during the mark of the beast and the image of the beast already being set up if we are going to be raptured before the tribulation even starts? That is a great question, but it assumes we means all 1.6 billion self-identified Christians around the world. It was Jesus that taught being born again was necessary to see the kingdom of heaven. John 3:3, Jesus answered and said to him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." John 3:5, Jesus answered, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." I would not wish that you remain ignorant of being born again. If your denomination or sect of Christianity does not teach this topic, I encourage you to read for yourself. Jesus was very clear that this point was critical. Too many people who call themselves Christian have no idea what being born again means. And that is a judgment on the ministry or clergy who have failed to understand the gospel. In summary, I do not think Revelation 20 verse 4 refutes or necessarily precludes the rapture. I do not think it is out of harmony with removal of Christians who actually have the authority to thwart the Antichrist. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.